Hey folks, Teacher Jason here, and we have a big announcement. I've got a new book out. It's called Wing Chun, Sil Lim Tao, and it's about, of course, guess this one, the first form, the Sil Lim Tao, the foundation of the whole system. And I'm excited about the book because if you've watched our series on the Sil Lim Tao stuff, you know that it's just chock full of amazing information and structure that you need. Now, a couple of things I'll say about the book. Number one, I've got the entire form in there, and each motion is broken down and captioned. So you don't only get, the movements, but you get the mind of the movement. Right? It's not so important that you can do something, do the movement, but know why you're doing the movement. This, one of the major things affecting and impacting Wing Chun adversely is that we're obsessing about the expression of a technique physically without knowing why it's being done that way. And we kind of hyperanalyze the angle of everybody's bong style and so forth without really understanding what this technique is supposed to be doing and the context it's going to be used in. That's the major reason I've come out with our YouTube channel and certainly these books. So if you buy the book, you're going to see the form in its entirety with a lot of detail and attention paid to getting you the mind behind the movements. The other thing is I break the form down as you see the opening. You know, even from the point of taking the breath, of knowing why that's so important to be able to calm down under stress, the necessity of using the stance, the Yi Ji Kim Yang Ma, the right way, because you're going to be in a varied environment where stable mobility is so important. You can't count on you having a nice padded environment to move around in. You're going to also see the necessity of the center line. People get confused over things like this. I'll just give you one tidbit. They think the center line is literally a thing rather than a concept about the thing, meaning the soft targets and the center of balance. I mean, trying to hit somebody's center line is redundant without knowing what the center line is pointing to. So we get into that in the book, and that is another critical piece of information. Knowing how to attack and simultaneously defend the body's weakest points. And then next, the interception concept, right? Of the Ji, kick and punch. And then the contact phase, which really sets Wing Chun apart from every other close quarter combat system of knowing how to tie guys up. Give you an example. You see with the bridge concept, it's in Western fighting arts, people think of clinching, this is grab a guy. But what I explain in the book is that contact is bridge, is think of D-Day. The hard part was getting that bridge head, getting that or a beachhead, and then you go after Hitler. You don't take the beach and then go out and go get another beach, right? That'd be stupid. You see a lot of people pop, pop, and coming in, bouncing back out. In real fights, once you take that beach, you better keep pressing forward. But getting that beach is hard. You can't, and a lot of people just don't understand the necessity of proper bridging in Wing Chun. I'm covering that for you so you know how to do that. And you know how to do it safely, pointing the way to it. And then one other thing is that the middle section, right? So you get the middle section, and we call that a defensive section because we have all of our great defensive techniques and defenses are right in the middle section of the form. And a lot of people forget that the first part of the form is giving us the structural and mechanical foundations of our optimal, when Wing Chun is working optimally. And then the middle section gives us our defensive structure and our fence. And then we get the last parts of it, which are gonna be your kind of mechanics and so forth. We finished the book with a series of chapters breaking all of those things down for you and then helping you again get the mind behind the technique. So you don't just, you know, stand there and do the technique and not know what to do with it. So it's sort of like an attempt is a private class and a book. So I hopefully you like it. Hopefully you like the material we're putting out. We're trying to do the best we can to get the best information out there for you guys that can't always get to a good Wing Chun school and so forth. As you know, we believe it's extraordinarily effective, you know, real comprehensive, but simple. And that's a key distinction, self-defense system for you. So hopefully check the book out. We have the links below. Click the like and subscribe button, okay? If you haven't done that already, it really means a lot to us. If you don't, and you keep taking all this great content, you know what's gonna happen? somebody's gonna find a really bad old photo of you. You know, like you're gonna have like some 80s, you have a mullet or something with a fanny pack, and it's just gonna be really embarrassing. So do the right thing, click the like and subscribe button. And I can't thank you guys enough for your support. Hopefully you guys like the book, and catch you next time.